Welcome to the Climate Crisis, addressing five key areas for change. This lesson is water. We will explore some of the ways the rapidly changing climate is impacting water resources globally. Water risk, including flooding and drought, has tremendous social, economic, and financial implications. Timely solutions for mitigation and adaptation, especially through innovative technologies, investments, collaborations, and holistic approaches are critical, as they provide multiple benefits and support for community resilience. This lesson was written by Dr. Shama Parveen, an international water, food, energy, climate nexus expert with over 20 years of interdisciplinary training and experience. Dr. Parveen has conducted research in India, Southeast Asia, and the U.S., and facilitated cross-sectoral partnerships for sustainable water resource management, advocating for science-based policy. The climate crisis is a systemic problem, global in scope, but visible locally. It affects water, food, energy, industry, and economic sectors in complex ways. Dr. Parveen says the multiple water-related risks worsened by climate change, population, and urbanization manifest in the following ways. Climate variability and water stress. According to the United Nations, 40% of the world's population is already affected by water scarcity. With shifting rainfall patterns globally and droughts and floods becoming more recurrent, the problem of too much, too little, or polluted water will impact industry, agriculture, and energy sectors more. Groundwater depletion. The water crisis is closely tied to industrial agriculture, where more than half of the irrigation water used to grow the world's food is supplied from groundwater. Ready access to pumped wells has ushered in unsustainable withdrawals of water from the aquifers globally, exceeding the rate of natural recharge. Critical in aiding climate adaptation, especially during times of need, globally the groundwater aquifers are already in crisis, much like surface water. Industry and economic water risks. The World Bank estimates that by 2050, water scarcity in some regions could impact GDP growth by up to 11.5%. Since 2000, flood-related disasters have increased by 134%, impacting transportation networks and disrupting the supply chains of several major industrial sectors. Freshwater shortages and pollution limit industry and agricultural production and disrupt the global supply chain networks and the economy in significant ways. As climate impacts worsen the water situation globally, Dr. Parveen writes, there are numerous solutions to respond to the water crisis. Water footprint and virtual water trade. The water footprint calculates the amount of water used to produce a particular good or service. By completing a water footprint assessment, a company or country can measure its dependence on freshwater and adjust production and trade accordingly. A cup of coffee, for instance, needs 140 liters of water to produce. The virtual water trade has been suggested as a possible solution lever to solve the water crisis in some regions like the Mediterranean, Middle East, Mexico, and Europe. Mexico, a water-poor country, saves 12 billion cubic meters of water annually by importing maize rather than producing it domestically using scarce water supplies. Water, food, energy nexus. Developing technologies and practices for better crop water and nutrient management, growing less water-intensive crops where water shortages exist, and growing crops to match the local climate can help alleviate stresses on water systems. Others include developing energy subsidy structures that influence water savings, reducing the carbon footprint of drinking water and wastewater systems, and promoting renewable energy, like solar-powered water pumps. Climate forecasts for water management. By utilizing climate forecasts, water managers and practitioners are equipped with data to make decisions regarding water allocations in times of scarcity. These forecasts make it possible to integrate supply and demand management. Water markets and rights. The value of water is much higher than the price when water is considered as an economic, social, and cultural good. For example, projects supporting indigenous and local populations in managing natural resources have been shown to deliver multiple benefits. Nature-based solutions. With natural systems deteriorating beyond a point of no return, nature-based solutions that weave natural features or processes into the built environment promote local adaptation and resilience and are more sustainable and cost-effective. Corporate stewardship and advocacy. Given the current water and climate crisis, the private sector has a significant role in shaping a more sustainable and water-secure future. Companies that are taking action to mitigate climate water risks seize new opportunities and also tap into growing markets, deliver on growing consumer and investor expectations, and boost their attractiveness as employers. The climate crisis requires a shift in thinking to an integrated approach to water, including technological innovation, pricing and regulation that promotes water conservation, circularity, and efficiency in order to meet human needs within ecological limits. It is critical that individuals, companies and investors, communities and governments implement mitigation and adaptation policies now. For more on this course and to access related resources, visit our website.